Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are diving into the essential world of links in Linux, which is one of the most important topics you need to understand. So why do we need links in the first place? And what are their main types? In Linux, a link is simply a shortcut or a reference to a file, helping you organize your system efficiently without duplicating data. There are two types of links, hard and soft, or also known as symbolic, each with its own unique functionality. Let's start from the basics. In Linux, each file has two main parts, its name and its actual data. A structure called inode is what links the file name to the file's content. It also holds important metadata like the file type, file size, owners, and timestamps. So what's a hard link in Linux? A hard link is essentially a second name for the same file. You can use a name or a path to refer to the same exact inode. That means any changes to the file through one hard link will show up in the others as well. There is really no difference between the original file and the hard link. In Linux terms, they are both just links to the same data on the disk. By default, a link is created using the hard link type. You can use the ln command to create a hard link to an existing file. Wondering how to check if it's a hard link? Well, you can use the ls-l command. When you list files in long format, you will see a number in the second column. This number shows the link count, or how many hard links point to the same data. In this case, it's 2. We can also check the inode number to confirm that indeed those links point to the same inode. To do that, we need to add the I flag to the ls command. So why would one use a hard link? Hard links can be used like a smart shared pointer in C++. You can access the same data from different paths and names, and the actual data is removed only when removing the last hard link. So it's perfect to use a hard link as a backup path to avoid accidental deletions. On the flip side, we have symbolic links, or symlinks, which let you point to the same file from different locations. The key difference is that while hard links reference inodes directly, symlinks refer to other files by their names. So a symbolic link has its own inode with its own metadata, but it has the linked file name or path as its data. To create a symlink, you still use the ln command, but this time you add the s flag to indicate that you want to create a symbolic link. And you can identify symlinks using the ls-l command, which nicely presents the symlink as a file that points to another file or path. In addition, the type of the file would be l, indicating that it's a symbolic link. One common use of symlinks is to manage different versions of installed softwares. For instance, on my system I have two Python 3 versions, Python 3.12 and Python 3.13, and a symbolic link Python 3 that points to whichever version I want to use. Another unique cool feature about symlinks is that you can link a directory. In my system, I have a symlink to access an external SD card for easy access. Unlike hard links, if we remove or rename the original data file, we would end up with a broken symbolic link that points to non-existing data. So precautions are necessary here. To wrap up, Linux links are crucial for efficient file management, allowing us to organize and access files without duplication. We covered two types, hard links, which link directly to the data, and symbolic links or symlinks that refer to files by name. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more Linux tips.